Welcome to Lusk, learn unknown, share known. Today we are going to watch about difference between ship electricity and your home electricity. Before watching that, we will see how electricity reaches your home. For that, you need to understand some basic things. What is current, what is voltage, and what is resistance. I will give a basic example so you will understand very easily. Imagine this is a tube. Inside the tube there is some water, and when we blow air from the one side of the tube, the other side of the tube water splashes. Here's the example. Water is in current, and what you blow air, that is called voltage, and the tube is called your cable, normal wire. Okay, when you blow your air, when we blow faster, the air moves faster and water goes very faster. When you blow slowly, the water reaches other part very slowly. The same thing applies in electricity also. When voltage is fast, current moves faster. Voltage is slow, current moves slow. You have definitely experienced in your home, sometimes your fans will be rotating slowly. That is because of low voltage. Same thing. Voltage is nothing but a force which pushes the current, electrons. This is called voltage current. Now let's see what is resistance. In same tube, if there is some choke, then that is stopping the water flow. Definitely when we blow the air, the water flow will be reduced. This is called resistance, which resists the electrons. That is called resistance. Now let's see how electricity reaches your home. This is a simple diagram of a power plant alternator, a power plant generator, where you can see there are three winding, Z mark, that is a three windings are there, R, Y, B, that will be rotating. When rotating, the electricity is produced, right? From the center tapping, the neutral is taken. So these generators will be high voltage generators, which will produce like 11 kV to 26 kV or more, according to the design of the power plant. And it is a high voltage generator. Now let's see how it reaches your home. From power plant, it is passing to a step up transformer, where the voltage is built up higher. Why we are step upping the voltage? Because when voltage increase, current will decrease. So conductor size, the cable size for transferring the current, electricity, that size will reduce. For that purpose, we are stepping up the voltage, and from there it goes to the substation, where they again reduce the voltage, step down the voltage from 180 to 765 kV to 11 kVA. Whatever voltage comes, they will step down to 11 kVA. Again, from substation, it will come to your street, where there is a transformer kept. That transformer does that 11 kVA, it will step down to 440 voltage for your home use. So they will reduce from 11 kV, 11,000 voltage, to 440 again. From there, it will reaches your house. How it is coming to 220? I will show you now. From the street transformer, output will come 440. Red, yellow, blue, each phase having 440, 440, 440. And one more thing is neutral. That is taken from the transformer also. Then it is one neutral. Each ohm have one neutral and only one phase. Not two phases, only one phase. So one phase and neutral together is 220 voltage. This is how you get electricity to your home. Now we will see the difference between ship electricity and home electricity. In ship, we don't have neutral. That is a major difference. In home electricity, in your home, in the home socket, we have phase neutral. But in ship, there is no neutral. So we use phase and phase. That we will see in detail. This is a ship alternator diagram. There is no neutral taken from the generator. But in power plant, they will take a neutral point from their generator. This shows ship don't have neutral, home have neutral. Let's see, without neutral, how a equipment work. see the diagram here, right hand side, right side, there is an iron box that is getting face red one, neutral black one. Same applies in the left side from alternator generator, which produce 440 voltage, and we use one transformer to step down again 440 to 220. But in your home use na, from the transformer 440 directly coming to your home, that is only one phase is coming. But here that 440 we are stepped down into 220, so there will be three phase and two phase we will use for the equipment. I mean R and Y, red and yellow we will use for an iron box, two phase. But here in home we use only red and black is neutral taken from the transformer. So here this is how we use a equipment without neutral. Now let's see what happens, what is advantage of having without neutral system, I mean isolated neutral system. See, in home right hand side there is an iron box, okay, and iron box is having some fault, something gone wrong inside the iron box, so current started leaking. After keeping the iron box to the earth, what happens, current flows to the earth, then there is a fault occurs. Because of the fault, high current is flowed and fuse will be blown off or MCB will trip. So even one earth fault, any one fault will trip the MCB or fuse will blow off. But in ship, what happens if there is one earth fault in iron box, one phase and it will touch the earth, but nothing will happen because there is no neutral in ship. So even one earth fault is there, there will be no trip or no fuse blown. But in ship, if there is two earth fault, I mean one earth fault in iron box, we are having one washing machine and that is also giving earth fault, I mean R and blue getting earth fault, then what happens, via earth the blue and red will get shot, that time there will be a trip and both equipment will be fused, I mean MCP will trip. This is the advantage, I mean one earth fault is allowed in ship. This is a major advantage in the ship. There is no neutral in ship. Then in ship we use 60 Hz frequency, in home we are using only 50 Hz frequency. Before knowing what is 50-60, let's know what is frequency. Frequency is nothing but which calculate electric current, okay, means 1 Hz equal to 1 cycle per second. So in your home we are using 50 Hz, means 50 cycle in 1 second. A example I will give, if there is a bulb, normal bulb in your home, if you fit a slow motion camera, you can see that bulb will be on off 50 times in 1 second. That is called the speed of the current, you can say like speed, 50 times it will on and off, it is not continuously on. When you keep on slow motion camera, you can watch carefully, 50 times it will on off, on off, on off, on off. That is called 50 Hz. In ship, we are using 60 Hz. This is a simple example I gave for you. There is a 1000 RPM motor in your home. Example like some motor, your water pump, anything, any motor which rotate 1000 RPM. The same equipment, if you take to the ship and connect, it will run in 60 Hz. I mean, RPM will increase 20%. That is, if 1000 RPM motor is connected in 60 Hz, it will rotate 1200 RPM. Same wise, if you decrease the frequency, RPM will decrease. If you increase the frequency, RPM will increase. This is what we are using in our inverter AC, inverter fridge, etc. Inverter technology, na? We are using VFD, variable frequency drive, which will increase or decrease the speed of the motor without varying the torque. Torque won't change, only speed will change. This is what we are using in inverter AC, etc., etc. I will discuss this deeply in upcoming videos. I hope you all understand what I said. If any mistakes, please correct me. Let's see in the next video how we are producing drinking water in ship and how to make your home shockproof. I mean, if you touch electricity at live also, you will not get shock. How to make that circuit and then how to reduce your electricity bill, I will upload in next upcoming videos. Thank you for watching. Learn unknown, share known.